Hey everyone, this is Chad, and in this video we'll be going over some of our top 10 basic tips and tricks for the new Samsung Galaxy Note 4. And while some of you more polished Android users may recognize some of these tips, chances are you'll learn at least 3 or more things that will up the functionality of your new Galaxy Note. I also have a written version of this video on my website, which will be linked in the description, so step-by-step directions are something you think would be helpful, then be sure to check that out as well. Anyway, be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy it, and let's go ahead and get started. Now the first tip we'll be going over is how to change your home or lock screen wallpaper, and the easiest way to do this is to start by long holding the screen. Then go ahead and choose wallpaper and toggle whether you would like to change the home and lock screen, or just one of them. In my case, I'm going to change the home screen, and as you can see here, it looks great. Now the second tip we'll be showing off is how to add and remove home screens, and again just go ahead and do a simple long hold on one of the home screens, and from here we need to identify which one of them we would like to remove. Once you find it, long hold it and drag it into the trash can to remove it. And then you can also move the order of the screens around here and set the main screen by tapping this home button. You can add a screen by simply navigating all the way to the right and then tapping on the plus button, and you can do it as many times as you want to add a bunch of home screens. So tip number 3 is adding apps and widgets to our home screen, and to do this we'll need to go into our app drawer and find the app or widget we're looking for. So like before, we'll long hold the screen, but this time we'll long hold on that specific app or widget of our choice. And upon doing that, we can go ahead and drag the item to wherever we would like. The process is completely identical with widgets, so you can do this with them as well. And for tips 4 through 6, we'll be demonstrating everything you'll need to know about the app drawer and how to customize it to your taste. So first we'll be going over how to hide and unhide apps. And the main reason that you would want to do this is because of carrier bloatware like the AT&T Family Map and any other apps that come pre-installed that you just never use. So the first step is to tap the 3 little dots on the top right hand corner of the app drawer and then click hide/unhide apps. Next, go ahead and check the apps you would like to hide, and then tap done, and they'll be gone. Now, they'll still be on your device, but they'll just be hidden from you. Next is what order the apps will be displayed in within your app drawer. So, this can be customized with your own individual custom layouts or in alphabetical order. And you can choose this by navigating again to the app drawer, and then tapping those same 3 dots on the top right-hand corner, and then tapping sort by. From here, you can either choose, like I mentioned earlier, custom or alphabetical. And you may have already noticed that I actually have a folder in my app drawer called Google, and to add a folder, you can go ahead and tap on the right hand corner, select create folder, and enter a name of your choice, and then you can check all of the apps you would like to add, similar to the way we hid apps, and then go ahead and press done to complete the action. And now you have a folder within your app drawer. Tip number 7 is how to customize the quick settings within your notification panel. And if you're not familiar with the notification panel, it's the circular icons that you can quickly toggle on and off when you pull down the notification bar. It's the items like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and those that you can slide across and toggle on and off. And you can edit these by tapping on the right-hand corner within the notification panel and then tap on the pencil icon. From here, we can follow the written instructions on the screen you can see here. And then you can go ahead and rearrange the order of them by dragging and dropping. Tips 8 and 9 are how to change the text size and font style on the Galaxy Note 4. So step 1 is to go ahead and open up your settings, swipe over to device, tap on display, tap on font, and from there you can choose the size of the text and also the font it will be in. Now our final tip is setting up the fingerprint scanner. And the easiest way to do this is by going into the settings and then searching for finger scanner. You can do this by, like I mentioned, either searching for it or actually physically looking through all the settings. Either way, you'll get to the same place. And then from here, you'll tap on fingerprint manager and then continue through the steps by swiping your finger down across the home button. And you can add a bunch of different fingers to completely customize the finger scanner to your liking. So that right there was 10 basic tips and tricks for the new Samsung Galaxy Note 4. If you have any other questions or if you ran into any issues, be sure to check out the written version of this video as it might be a bit easier to follow along. If you're still having trouble after that, then feel free to let me know what's going wrong in the comment section down below, and I'll do my best to help out. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful, and subscribe to the channel as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.